Today, I'm going to teach you how to meet and how to communicate with your dream guide. But first, allow me to make the biggest disclaimer in the world. There are, in my opinion, many different names for the same thing that I'm going to be teaching you. Some will call it spirit guide, some will call it astral guide, some will call it spirit animal, others call it higher self or subconscious or unconscious mind. I believe that all of these names pertain to the same thing that in this video I'm going to refer to as dream guide. It has to also be said that the term dream guide isn't my preferred term. I prefer the term subconscious. Now, the reason there are so many different names for the same thing, in my opinion, has to do with your beliefs. For example, I prefer to call it a subconscious because I believe we dream in the mind. If we dream in the mind, there is nothing higher than consciousness. So I can't say higher consciousness. Can't really call it spirit guide because I don't believe we dream in an astral plane, so there's no spirit. But we can see because the sun's too bright. So if you hear me say subconscious instead of dream guide, that's why. But it all pertains to the same character in your dream. Also, one thing to note, the character of the dream guide has no scientific value. There is no quantifiable data, there's no science behind it, which, as we all know, I don't particularly enjoy. So everything that I'm going to be teaching you today is going to be off my experiences and the experiences of a few other people I know. So take that with a pinch of salt. Everything that I'm going to be talking to you about today lies in this grey area. But with that out of the way, let's talk about how to do it. Before we start today, I'd just like you to take a moment to realise the beauty of that blue sky in front of me and that grey cloud behind me. It's actually, you can see the rain. I don't know how well that's picking up. I got a bee out in my house before that hits me. That rainbow's moving closer towards me. I'm outrunning the rain. I don't know if you can tell, but the rain is, oh God, it's coming. I can see it on the sea. So if I can get into this underpass bit before it hits me and my camera, I'll be happy. Can you see that? That white speckles? That's the rain on the sea. Well, that's kind of right. I still want my camera to get wet. Oh, it's getting wet. My camera's getting wet. It's more hail than anything. That's one of the advantages of living next to the sea. You can, if it's heavy rain, you can see when it's gonna start. Okay, so whilst I stand here for a little bit, whilst the rain passes over me, step one, you've got to be in a lucid dream. Now, a lucid dream is any dream in which you're aware that it is a dream as you're in it. If you're thinking that you're gonna be able to communicate with your dream guide without knowing about lucid dreaming, you're mistaken. So if you don't know how to lucid dream or you don't know what a lucid dream is, I've made a good tutorial, I've made a few good tutorials about how to become lucid in a dream. So follow those step-by-step instructions and hopefully you'll be on your way. Step two, to be aware, very aware that you're in a dream. This means your layer of lucidity has to be higher than normal. Not too much higher. I'm not saying to be ridiculous amount of lucidity, but I mean, you've got to be aware enough that you can take somewhat slight control over your dream. But not only slight control over your dream, but you want to be able to remember it. So try and get to that point of lucidity in which your memory in the dream is exactly what you need it to be in waking life. Because when you meet your dream guide, he might give you some really interesting bits of information. You don't want to forget that now, do you? No, no siree Bobby Jim. If you don't know how to rise through the layers of lucidity, again, I made a tutorial on it, link in the description box below. Step three, manifesting. Now, manifesting your dream guide can happen in a number of different ways. The way that I see a dream guide is that it's an aspect of my subconscious. So because of this, because I think of it as me, but on a lower down level, I stand in front of a mirror and my reflection is my dream guide, my subconscious. I then try and picture that mirrored image in front of me, but not in the mirror. Then the dream guide usually appears for me. But as I've said, this is because I think of it as my subconscious and therefore it is me in a way. So depending on how you view your dream guide, the manifesting part will depend solely on how you believe your dream guide to look, or what your beliefs of a dream guide are. So me manifesting my subconscious as me, that's the way that I do it, because that's the way I picture my dream guide. Rhys Jones, however, on the other hand, he used to, I don't know what he does now, but he used to think that his dream guide was his higher self, therefore pertaining to a little bit of spirit, or above the person of you. Because of this, Rhys will just call out to the dream world, "I want to meet my higher self." He made a video on it, I'll link it below if I can remember what it's called. I think it's just called Meeting My Higher Self. For those of you who think of dream guide as spirit guide, this clearly indicates that you feel it on a more spiritual level. So the way that I would suggest is probably through meditation. I did a video a couple days ago about senses in a lucid dream, teaching you the very easy, simple way to meditate. But if you know your own meditation skills, by all means do that. Now that you've manifested your dream guide, talk to it. Let's get real. I need to talk to you about the advantages and disadvantages of talking to a dream guide and why it's not as reliable as you think. First of all, the obvious thing. There's no guarantee that the character you've just manifested is actually your dream guide, or is actually your higher self, or your spirit guide, or whatever. There is a chance, and it's a big chance, that this character that you've just manifested is actually just that, a dream character. That means all the wisdom that this dream guide just gave you, all the answers to the questions you've been asking, have been completely irrelevant. You have to be very vigilant about the stuff that you ask and the stuff that you get back. You've got to examine it, because you might do something in waking life just because this dream guide, who might not be just a dream guide, has talked to you about. I do believe that I have been in contact with my subconscious, but it's different for me because I see it as my subconscious. That means everything in the dream is technically my dream guide. The character I talk to is created from my brain, so I can talk to just a random stranger. I can talk to a chalkboard and have the chalkboard respond back to me with the answer to the question I've been talking to them about. The air that I breathe, the ground that I walk on, the grass that's in the field I'm standing in is all technically my dream guide. Because the way that I think of it, it's my subconscious. You could probably take that away for your belief. If you believe in spirit guide or higher self, then this could link to it too. Because if you believe that everything in your dream is actually in an astral field, an astral world, then it will all be spirit in sense. And because it's spirit, it's technically your dream guide too. I think the best example of something that I've discussed with a dream guide in my dream is when I did exactly as I told you. I looked into a mirror, manifested a person, blah, blah, blah. What I did is I spoke to them. I could have asked them any number of questions. This was the first time I talked to them. I could have asked him any number of questions. I could have said, "What should I do in my life?" which was a big question I needed answering. But the only thing I could think of was, "What's my greatest fear?" because I didn't know. The dream guide said dying alone. And it wasn't until retrospect afterwards, when I woke up and I was nearly towards the end of my day, that I realized that the words that my dream character said, my dream guide said, was spot on. And I just cried for ages. It's also a good idea that if you are trying to communicate with a dream guide, you might want to incubate your idea, your intentions beforehand. I should make a video on dream incubation. I've not done so yet, but I should. So once you've done dream incubation, basically what that means is that you set your intentions before you go to sleep. You incubate the idea in your mind. You visualize what you want to do. You visualize what you want to do in the dream, in your mind, as you're falling to sleep. You try and hone in on that concept so that the situation will present itself when you go into the dream more often than if you didn't. So that's my guide on talking to a dream guide. As I said, with these dream incubation ideas, you can actually write a physical list of stuff that you want to talk about to your dream guide and set that as like a goal. So when you do become lucid in a dream, then that's what you can do. Just cross it off once you've asked them. You can write it down in your dream journal, your response that they gave you, and see how it impacts your life. But proceed with caution, as I've said. And for the love of God, don't use dream guide as a ticket into trying to see the future. It's called a dream guide, not a dream oracle. They don't see the future. It just helps you do stuff that you needed to do within. So ask questions about yourself, about what's going on in here and what's going on in here, and how you can change your life to impact that of the world around you. Not what are the lottery numbers. Okay, that's that. Thanks everyone. And if you're a Patreon supporter, thank you very much for supporting. There's some names in the description box below to those who have donated two or more dollars. I just want to say that for Patreon, starting the 1st of February, if you're watching this before then, I will be releasing a video every other day exclusively to Patreon supporters. So if you want to be a part of that, all you have to do is go into the description box below, patreon.com/GizEdwards, and donate $1 or more each month to have all of that yummy exclusiveness. I think I've got 67 videos planned for Patreon exclusives, so released every other day. That'll take you until the middle of June. Just saying. It's a good deal. So until next time. Bye.